So the song Won't Be For Nothing, that song is kind of important to me because of obviously the topic. Memorial Day is coming up very quickly, and people always have this angst around Memorial Day because when someone thanks a military member for their service on Memorial Day, a lot of military people get really crabby about it, honestly, and they're like, don't thank me, thank the guys who didn't make it back, because civilians don't necessarily know the difference. Armed Forces Day is for active, Veterans Day is for us that are vets, and Memorial Day are for the ones who didn't make it back. So when someone thanks you for your service on that day, it's not that we don't appreciate that you appreciate the military, but it's very personal because survivor's guilt is such a problem amongst the military. You know, like, why did I make it home and they didn't? And so I have a couple of views on that for Memorial Day. I think that if someone thanks you for your service, just say thank you. I mean, just say thank you. They're not doing it from a bad place. And explain to them why it's not necessarily for you. And tell them about the person that you lost, why it matters to you. That could just bridge this huge education gap between civilians and veterans, and let them know. And then the other thing is people get mad when you barbecue. So everyone treats it as this long 3-day weekend and it's barbecuing, and there's a lot of people get upset about that too and say, well, you know, it's to remember the fallen, you know, it's not for a barbecue. And my view, and this is just my view, is bullshit. Yes, it is. Those, our guys and ladies died so we get to live. They died so we can live. So live. I mean, I don't know a single veteran who, if they had not made it back, would tell you to sit around all day and pout and be sad. Yeah, be sad, memorialize them, I mean, miss them, talk about them, but then live, because they died for you to have the freedom to do so. And I think if they were here, they would want to be out hanging out with their family for the day and enjoying the fact that they get to live in this country. So I just don't have a problem with that, and that's really what this song is about. It's just to let people know that I don't know any of them that would martyr and say, could you just be sad all day? And then I get into the flag code side of it. Flag code for Memorial Day is, which most people don't know, they think it's just half mast. And it is until noon. You're supposed to put the flag at half mast until noon to mourn the fallen and then raise it gloriously to celebrate our nation's heroes of war. That is what flag code is. And so I think that it is so smart. Spend the time being sad, talk about the ones we lost, but then celebrate that you get to live, because you do, because of their sacrifice. And I do not think for one second that they would behoove us that celebration of life. And just because I was so unsure how that song would be received, because it is just my opinion, I did actually reach out to many Gold Star families. I know, unfortunately, many families who have lost somebody in the service, and I sent that song to all of them. And I said, you tell me if this song celebrates your lost loved one, or if it's upsetting to you. Because I wouldn't have put it out, my opinion or not, if, you know, Gold Star families would have been upset. And across the board, there was not one who said they didn't like it. They said, do it. That is what they would have wanted. And they said, put it out there. And so we are.
On my way to grab morning coffee, I walked past a flag flying low. A lady thanked me for my service, 'cause my Navy hat was shown. I said, Memorial Day, it isn't for me, it's for the ones who didn't make it home. So I told her stories about you and how we had to let you go. Let it be for nothing. the lake with our families, going fishing with the boys.